Rico. It's Denver Wine Radio.
Hey, it's Denver Wine Radio. Paul Buonacquisti, Cha-Cha Chavez.
Hello.
So, Denver Wine Radio, if you're new to this, we've been doing this for about 3 months now.
Yeah, about three months.
We were doing it on regular real radio.
Terrestrial radio, like going into a radio station.
Yeah, like going into a radio station. We were doing it down at Mile High Sports, talking about wine.
Mm-hmm. And music.
And music,
and
old school
Denver.
Music. That's right, Denver. And we taste wines from all over, and we compare them to Colorado wines.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of our focus. Colorado against the world.
Exactly.
So, but today is a brand new style of broadcast.
It is. We've come a long way, Paul.
We have. We came from 975 Lincoln down to, we're live inside the winery here. At my place, Buonacquisti Wine Company.
And the address?
4640 Pecos. Thank you for asking.
Right off of I-70. It's a nice place. It's a great place.
Thank you so much. So we're going to start doing this weekly here from the winery, tasting wines and seeing what you think. We're going to invite the people to come down. We have a small studio audience today. Would you like to see our studio audience?
Yes, let's see the studio
audience.
Okay, if
I get the right button.
See, there you go.
Yeah.
Yay.
thanks for coming, guys.
Yeah. We all have to start somewhere.
Yeah, we do. All right. So what's the deal today?
Well, over the last 3 months, we've had a lot of wine sampling. We've had expensive bottles of wine.
Yep.
We've had great tasting wines in cans.
Yep.
Which is the new thing now.
Yeah, we did. Yeah, we did 2 weeks of canned wine.
Yeah, and it was awesome.
Yeah, there was a lot of good canned wines.
And it's very easy to transport, and especially with summer and stuff coming up too. So if you think you want to take some wine up camping with you, a nice canned wine would be great. But today, Paul, I thought that I would choose wine based on labels.
That's a good idea.
And I'm not the only one that just buys bottles of wine based on labels.
No, yeah, a lot of people buy. That's why labels are so
exactly right?
friendly and try
exactly.
to relate to the customer. And yeah, so what did you go pick up today?
So today I picked up kind of the theme of, kind of my life. Freak Show is number one.
All right. Be careful. Those bottles are open.
Okay. Oh, they are open. Okay. Yeah. Sorry, Polly. Okay. And then this one is Gnarly Head.
You got some Gnarly Head. That's
yes.
a good one, too.
Because my hair is in that in-between stage. Women will understand. Hi, Judy. Do you understand? It's in that don't know what quite to do with it yet. And
okay.
What's this one?
And then that's a wine from my neighbor here, Riker Cellars,
okay.
and it's called Doggles.
It's
a dog wearing goggles.
On a scooter. Hey.
So.
He looks like he drank this bottle of wine, and it was very tasty. And he just went out for a cruise on the scooter.
Yeah, he went out on the scooter, his little little Vespa.
Yeah, little Vespa.
Yep.
So anyways, I brought in, and they're reds, because we decided to do reds today because it's May the 19th, but it's what? 50 degrees.
Yes.
Outside. So it's chilly. So we thought we'd get something that could warm the soul and the panza at the same time.
That's a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was very, because today, I was thinking we should have done some celebratory wines for the, because of the royal wedding.
Right.
And bring out some sparklers. And you know what? That's been the biggest secret. Everything about that wedding has been the secret. But the wine they were going to serve has been like the locked up secret.
Really?
Oh,
so
yeah.
What are they serving up?
I don't know what they're serving up.
Oh, they still didn't?
No. Yeah. And maybe it'll come out today.
Wow.
Because now the party's on. But
How do they pick that? Is it like a specific
something they probably like? Maybe
wow.
a producer that they like? And so if you are the producer of the wine and they came to you and said, hey, we're going to use your wine for the royal wedding,
yeah.
but you can't say anything. Of course, you're not going to say anything.
Yeah,
they'll never
yeah, right.
buy any wine from you again.
Right, right.
Yeah, so.
And do you think that they pay for the wine, or do you think the wine is given to them because it's a big honor for your vineyard to be chosen as the wine to be served at the royal
yeah,
wedding?
I'm sure they buy it.
Because we're not talking Boone's Farm.
Right. So, yeah, they're probably having something good. And yeah, and of course they're going to buy it.
They'll buy it.
Yeah.
I guess. I don't know. Would you give...
Where do they get all the...
Would you give the wine away?
For product placement? Yes, I would.
See? I would, too. There you go. I would, too. I'd say, here, take as much as you want. Spread it around.
Yeah, so... all right.
Okay, what are we going to taste first? So, do you want to taste the dog on the scooter? Do you want to taste Freak Show or...
Or the
Gnarly Head.
Yeah, let's go... let's try one. Let's go with Gnarly Head.
Okay.
And then we'll go try Rikers, and then we'll come back to the Freak Show.
Okay.
All right.
And then we can get some members of our studio audience to come and
sample. Oh, yeah, we'll get them involved, too. So.
Whoa, look at the color of this one, Paul.
That's pretty gnarly.
Oh, my God. That's peanut butter grape there.
Yeah,
right?
This one's pretty inky. And we're drinking Gnarly Head Authentic Black. Bold, sophisticated, ooh, hint of gnarly. And doesn't really tell us what's in it. And I didn't go look it up. So
it is
Lodi. It's from Lodi, California, 2015 vintage.
Lodi. That's, do you know, there's a song with
there is.
Lodi in the.
Yes,
in the,
there is.
What is it?
That's a Creedence Clearwater there Revival.
Bolly, ding, 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 ding. Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Thank you.
Yes, down in Lodi.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow, look at the color of this. Isn't this amazing? Check this out. Look how deep red.
I hear a duck quacking
yes.
in here. All right, we got more of the studio audience coming in. Thanks a lot. Welcome to Denver Wine Radio. You have the looks like Northside Nick.
Oh.
Who called us a few times over
Northside
on Mile
Nick,
High
what's
Sports.
Up? How you doing? This is really good. You know, it's very, it's sweet.
Does it taste sweet to you?
Yeah.
I haven't tasted it yet, but it smells real jammy.
Very jammy.
You know, a lot of dark fruit.
Yep. What do you think?
Mm-hmm.
Sweet, huh? Like almost desserty?
Mm. Yeah, this one, it's a little bit sweet.
Like a dessert, kind of. Or soaked peaches?
Not quite. I wouldn't say dessert. Because dessert wines are really technically a lot higher in sugar.
Oh, okay.
This one, it has this is made to drink in the backyard, barbecues. A little bit sweet. It's a hot day. It's going to go down.
Yeah.
But yeah, for a red wine, so how much was that bottle of wine? You remember? Because you just picked these up today at Total Beverage.
No, I think that one was only like $10.
Okay, that sounds about right for Gnarly Head.
$10, yeah.
Yeah, $10, authentic black.
Yeah.
Really inky. Probably some Zin, some Petit Sirah, I'm just guessing. But yeah, it's a little bit, it's really fruit forward, jammy, cocktailish.
You know, I think this would be good with the sangria. A little fruit in it?
You could throw some fruit in it, make sangria out of it, yes.
Don't you think? What do you guys think? Studio audience? It's a winner?
Oh, yeah.
Come here, Nick. Let's talk to Nick and see what he tastes in this wine. What did you taste, Nick?
It did have a fruit-forward flavor on it.
Let's go right
But
here.
I just finished up some Vinny. So it's hard to get. I'm going to have to clean my palate, and I'll get back to you on that.
Okay.
But it did have a lot of fruit-forward on it.
Okay, well, go wash your mouth out with soap and then come back. I'm just teasing.
All right, give me that dumper.
Yeah, this is good. I like this. It was sweet. It's a lot
sweeter,
but.
So you bought this for the label because it's got a cool label.
Gnarly.
And now what do you think after you tasting it? You're like, okay, good label.
Yeah, good wine.
Okay.
It is good. I mean, for $10, $10.99 or something like that, I mean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, whatever.
So it's good.
Okay, for me?
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever.
Okay.
I can let it go.
Okay.
All right. So now let's switch over to
your neighbors.
My neighbor. Yeah. Riker Cellars.
Okay. Wow. That's just as inky, too.
This is looking pretty good, too. Real inky. Riker Cellars. Red Wine. Doggles is the name of this label. And let's check this one out, too.
Not as fruity.
So this one's made right here on the north side.
Not as fruity. I mean, there's some there.
Yeah, more, yes. So, not as fruity, but, Yeah, this has more. This is more cherry.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was smelling. Cherries.
Yep.
Mm-mm. Oh.
All right. So this one.
Whoa. Not. I mean.
We probably should have tasted this one first before we went to the.
Because
after tasting a sweet, that sweet gnarly head, yeah. So his this has more acid to it.
More acid.
But definitely, this is a fruitier wine too. This is an easy drinker, but has a more acid and dry compared to the gnarly head. So
yeah, very much so, very much so. I mean, it's good, but
you prefer. Yeah, I know you. That's
sweet,
right.
Yeah.
So we got to tell. We got to give a little backstory here on. You know, we Cha Cha started 3 months ago with. No wine experience.
None.
Doesn't Zilch. Drink wine.
Don't drink alcohol at all.
Doesn't drink at all. That's right.
But now, hey, boy.
She's built a really nice vocabulary.
I have. Tannins. What other words have I learned?
You've thrown out some good adjectives recently, like bold.
Crisp.
Rustic. Yeah.
Yeah.
You've had.
No, seriously, in all seriousness, I mean, you really have taught me a lot, not only in the different kinds of grapes, because I just thought a grape was a grape was a grape.
Yeah.
I didn't know there was different types of grapes, hence different types of wine. Duh. I didn't get it. But now I get it. And now I can, like you just said, I just tasted this gnarly head as opposed to this Riker's, and I can so already taste the difference that I would have never 3 months ago gone, well,
right.
This one, I don't know.
But now that you're tasting side by side or tasting a bunch of wines, you know what you like and what you don't like.
Exactly.
Right.
And I like the ones that lean a little on the sweeter side. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I'm so sweet. But this is good. This was good. But it's like you with the gnarly head, I could leave it.
Yeah. And then Riker's comes in at, I don't know, I think $16 or $18, something like that.
Okay.
So.
And the next one I brought in is called Freak Show.
Yeah, Freak Show.
And look how dark that one is too.
Whoa.
Sorry, Polly.
So Freak Show is another, Freak Show is a one made by Michael David Winery. They're in, this is Grayton, but I know they're in Lodi. They have a place in Lodi.
In Cali?
Yeah, in Cali. And so we've been to that winery. They make a lot of different wines. They make... You know, Seven Deadly Zins. It's a big label.
What? Seven Deadly Zins?
Seven wow. Deadly Zins. So, yeah. So let's give this one a whirl. What's, I don't know, what does it say it's in it?
I couldn't read the label, Paul.
I can't read either. You just picked it up for the label.
Just,
doesn't matter. We're
going to
drink it. That's why it's the label show today.
It was called Freak Show.
We're tasting wines for the labels.
Yes, the Freak Show.
And how much was this one?
Man, this one put me on spam for all next week. It's $20. Yep.
He blew your whole government check.
I blew my government check. Got to eat spam, but now they have it with jalapenos. They do. I love fried spam and mustard sandwiches. Shut up. They do. It's their number one food.
Okay. So this one's... This one's really good. Not as no. You're giving me the pucker face.
Mm-mm.
No.
Mm-mm.
Spit it out. Taste it again.
Mm-mm.
All right. So this one, this one's dry. Smells like it has some Cabernet in it. I don't know what else, but that's what kind of comes through to me. And I actually like this one.
You do?
Yeah.
See, I'm not feeling it, Polly, at all.
I like the Rikers.
You like the Rikers?
This has a little more tannin to it than you're used to, probably. And you need something to combat that tannin for you to drink this wine.
It's very woody.
It is. It's got it has some more oak. It is structured because of the grapes that are in this, but has a lot of good fruit to it. And yeah, that's a good one.
I can smell the fruit, a lot of fruit.
I gotta go to the side camera now.
Oh, Polly.
Yeah.
Oh no, freak show muy mal. I don't like that one. No, no.
Well,
that's not good. You can keep this one.
Okay. I'll keep that one. You could take that one home and then we'll share. Yeah, but it is. See, it's got it's a cool label.
It's the coolest label until you open it.
So
it was very, very dry.
Okay, so here's something we want to try.
Too much acid.
If anybody's watching in the live audience, let's see if I can put up the right graphic here. We have a request line, and I just put the phone number up. Okay, 720-445-6644. We'll play your song, and we'll answer a wine question if you have it. So we'll just sit here and wait for the phone to ring. But in the meantime,
have you been baking lately, Polly?
Yeah. All right. So in the meantime, let's talk about Chaw's Back in the Day Cafe. Yep, Chaw's launching an online radio station. Playing all the old school from all the days that you spent here in Denver radio.
Yeah. We play a little rock. We play a little soul. Mostly soul and R&B. Old school R&B. But, yeah.
Okay.
It'll be fun. It'll be a whole lot of fun. We'll go back in the day. Like when we'd go to Lakeside for concerts and Coos Federal. And
yeah. And you know what? Lakeside's getting a new roller coaster.
What?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Do they still have that wooden one?
They do. Yeah, they have the wooden, the Cyclone.
What's it called? Trivia? The Cyclone? Is that what it is? Wow, they're getting a new one, like state of the art, kind of like.
Yeah.
No, it's a refurbished.
Oh, it's is it really refurbished? Oh, really? Man, Nick knows. See? That's why he's Northside Nick.
Man. Dude, it's not one of those that came from the parking lot at the Kohl's, right? Those little carnivals they set up. Wow. Lakeside. That's one of the best.
And yes. Yeah. Anything. I know. A new roller coaster at Lakeside is a big deal.
Yeah, it is a big deal. When do you know when it's supposed to, like this summer?
I think they're still working on it. I think this summer. I thought I read something like in June, late June. Or
wow.
It's going to, it's, yeah.
Wow.
And
we should
another,
all get together and go write it.
Hey, now check this out. In other Northside news.
What?
You won't even believe this. Okay, so Food and Wine Magazine a couple of weeks ago put out an article with the best burritos from around the country. The 50 best burritos. So they won from every state.
Okay.
Okay, so the burrito they picked for Colorado is from La Fuente. Right up here at 44th and Federal.
Really?
Yeah.
Out of the whole, like, city, state, whatever?
Out of the whole state, yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So I went over there yesterday morning, and I sat down, and I want the world's best burrito.
It was the world's best?
Oh, yeah. It was really good. It was the best. A guy, Jose, he was cooking. I was the only one in there. So I sat down. I said, yeah, I want to eat it here. So, and he said, what do you want? You know, chorizo, what do you want in it? Because he was cooking up an order of 60 burritos.
Wow.
Yeah, because of the article. Somebody
That's
called
awesome.
In an order for 60. But, yeah, so I got the smothered deluxe with the chorizo. It was super good.
Right
on. So rather, I don't want to start a burrito war, but you all have your favorites, I'm sure. And they probably are in Pueblo or something like that.
Yeah. Pueblo with that,
yeah,
that kind of green chili
Pueblo's
they got
in the
down
house.
There. Yeah, that Pueblo green chili that always comes in second to Hatch.
There's our live studio audience.
Yeah, because you know,
so
Hatch is where the chili's at.
So Nick, yeah, have you ever been up there?
It's been a while. They changed ownership, but I used to go in there a lot for the express burritos because they really
Yeah. Okay. It's time to go back. Oh, Tacos Jalisco. Yeah, very good. Yeah, very good. And then tamales by La Casita. Yeah. Yeah, Pochitos, yeah. Oh, I know it. So, see, the North Side's got a lot of...
The North Side has a lot of... Yeah, you know, like great burritos. Food.
So.
Food and wine.
There's different regions of Mexico, not just one region, just different regions. They're not all the same.
Like, what do you mean?
Like, Jalisco's is a region in Mexico. They make their own style of Mexican food.
Right.
Like wow. Like the southern food in America here, you know, they all
right.
We're going to have to hook up a microphone out for the studio audience
I
next
week. I think we should. I think we totally should.
My call-in line, it's on the screen. It's 720-445-6644.
It's the Vinny No-Neck hotline.
That's the North Side hotline
the
right
North
there.
The North Side hotline.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right. Downtown it was the Vinny No-Neck hotline. But
is it calling? Oh, okay.
Oh.
We got Tammy Q.
All right, let's stand
talking
by.
Talking about somebody who knows the North Side. Híjole, she's like Siri for the North Side. You want to know anything about the North Side, you just go. Or anybody in the North Side. That's right. You just ask Siri. She'll tell you. Ask Tammy.
All right, so... Well, we're waiting for the phone to ring.
We totally look like a Saturday Night Live skit. So tell me about your schwitty balls.
Yeah, it might be time to wrap this up.
See, what did I tell you? After three good sips, I got me a buzz.
Yeah. So, well, all right. That's it for this week. The Label Show.
The Label Show. Does anybody have any questions? Please. Anything. Ask us about potholes on I-70. We don't care. Well, yeah. I purchased them from a little liquor store around the corner from my house in Thornton. Thornton?
Oh, I'm sorry. We have a phone call?
Oh, we do. Okay.
Hi, welcome to Denver Wine Radio. You're on the air.
Hey, Wine Radio friends. It's your friend TQ. How are you?
What's happening, TQ?
Going on. I love your show.
Oh, well, thank you. Can you hear us okay?
I can hear you just fine.
Oh, you know, great. You're the only one.
What's happening?
That loves the show. You're special.
Well, I wanted to call and put in a request.
And put in a request?
Yes.
Okay, a North Side request. You're from the North Side, right?
That's right.
Yeah. We were just talking about you off mic. No, actually, we were on mic.
Wow.
So your phone should be blowing up
so
soon.
Please, what's going on? How are things going on down there? I just wanted to call in and say how much I love your show and wanted to put in a request. And congratulations, Chai. You know, I know you guys have been working really hard at this, and I'm really proud of you. So
not so much.
You know, I just wanted to call in to show some love.
Thanks, Tammy. Appreciate it. TQ.
TQ.
Thanks, TQ. Sorry,
from the North
secret names today. I forgot. Oh yeah. So hey, have you ever eaten over at La Fuente, 44th and Federal? What's that?
Have you ever eaten at La Fuente?
I'm getting a little bit of feedback. I'm not quite
come
clear
on.
What you're saying.
We don't have technical issues here.
Okay, stand by.
Have you ever eaten at La Fuente?
Okay, how's that? Is there feedback now?
Okay, sounds a little better. Okay.
So have you ever eaten over at La Fuente, 44th and Federal?
La Fuente on 44th and Federal. Yes, I have. I've had some breakfast there. They've had some, I think I had some menudo there one morning.
Oh, right on. Because, you know, Food and Wine magazine, they put out the 50 best burritos in the United States, and they won Colorado.
Yeah, I've had some good meals there. It's a great place, great family-owned restaurant.
So do you know any of them there that work there, or?
I don't know the family.
What? Oh, they're newer owners. Because we were just talking about how you know everybody on the north side, so we just figured you knew them.
Well, yeah, unfortunately, I don't know them, but they do have some good food there, so.
Right on.
But I just wanted to call in and show some love, and I wanted to put a request in if you have an opportunity.
Yeah, what is it?
Squeeze in some Herb Alpert Rise.
Some what?
Herb Alpert Rise?
Herb Alpert Rise. Oh.
Yeah, Herb Alpert Rise.
I remember.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
I was just like,
acting
of
like
all
you don't remember.
The songs on the planet. Were you in North Korea with those dudes or what? Did you just get released? I'm sorry. No, that's
so
a good song. I like the one with Janet, the one that Herb Alpert does with Janet. What song is that
you
one?
You know what? Herb Alpert, great artist, great song. If you have an opportunity, squeeze it in for me.
Okay.
You guys enjoy the rest of your day, and we'll definitely see you soon. Keep
okay,
up the good
Tim.
Work.
Right on, TQ.
Care, much left. Bye.
Bye. Dude, what's the name of the song with Janet and what is it? Diamonds? Diamonds.
Yeah, I think it is Diamonds.
Diamonds.
Yeah.
Diamonds are a girl's best friend or something like that, right? No.
Yeah,
just Diamonds. And then did Janet do one with Luther? Did she do a duet with Luther? Skinny Luther or Fat Luther? He did? They did?
Yep.
Meet on Nick from the North Side, full of trivia.
He is, man. He's got it all. All right.
I'll take trivia for 500.
It's time to wrap
Nick?
This up. Okay. Well, yeah, thanks everybody for being here in the studio audience. Thank you for watching our first live in-house show of Denver Wine Radio. We'll do it next week.
Yeah.
And we'll get some more wine and we'll, you know, I want to do boxed wine because there's some boxed wine in Colorado now.
Okay.
So I'm thinking about that. And there's a lot of other, there's so many more wines. So
do you think wine will ever come in a keg?
Oh, come on, John. Of course, wine is in a keg.
Well, not like a keg like this. You're
no,
not gonna like.
That's all we love keg wine.
Oh, it comes in a keg?
Yes.
Dude, I didn't know that. I thought it came out of these little things, these big things right here.
It comes out of the big things, and then we put it in kegs, and that's how we fill our growlers.
Excuse me while I have another drink. None of that one. Give me the sweet one.
Okay. That'll be enough of that. So your job this week is to put some altitude in your glass.
And not in a keg.
And then, join us next time on Denver Wine Radio. I got to work.